Hi, I want to talk about everything that's going on right now in our country, something that I'm very concerned about. I'm going to try not to be political, but I'm getting ready to start a sentence with something you should never start it with in our day and time. So please just bear with me. Don't go crazy. But Donald Trump, see, you're already said something. Might have been a month ago. I don't even know what day it is. Is it August? I mean, really? He said when they were talking about the effects of the virus and causing it could cause millions to die or thousands to die, they didn't know. They still don't know. And he said something I thought was, and it was, quite frankly, it was a little the way he said it was, as always, insensitive. But he said, well, when people start killing themselves because they're losing everything, you're going to see that can be pretty damaging as well. And he was trying to say that the financial destruction that was getting ready to occur could cause more damage in the long run than the virus. Well, I'm not a doctor. I played one on the radio once, but I'm not a doctor, so I don't want to go down that road. But what I do want to address is what he said. Because today, a few more of my friends lost their job. And for them, their jobs were part of their dream. They were literally had their dream job. They had were gaining financial security, and it was ripped out from underneath them. People are going to, over the next few months, lose homes. They are losing their life savings. They're losing small businesses that, again, were their dream and were their heart. And some of you watching this may be that person, and you gotta hang on. It is so easy for when our financial structure begins to crumble to think that that's all we are and that's all we have, and that we have to live in the big home and we have to drive the nice car. And trust me, I love my car. I love nice things. But we got to remember, we can get back there. We may lose some things. We may not be able to buy the clothes we want to buy or have our kids even in the schools we want to have them in. But at the end of the day, we got to stick together. Do not choose a permanent solution to a temporary problem. I know I've been there when I felt like there were no other options. I remember praying one time that God would take me in my sleep, because it seemed it would be better than the life I was living. And let me just tell you, after all the times in my life, at my age of 53, I've gone through some really tough times. And I've hung in there, and I'm always glad I did. I'm always glad I did. Because at the end of the day, you know what's really important? I get to see my granddaughter, Eileen, who is going to grow up to be a beautiful daughter. And I'm going to get to be a part of that. And I'm going to continue to have friends. I'm going to continue to one day, I'm going to have that special person in my life, and it's going to be amazing. And the same is true for you. The money, the things, they're all, I know they're fun. Vacations are amazing, but that's not what's most important. So as we go through this crazy time in life, please, 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 remember, you're more than a house, more than a car, more than a 401k. You are dearly loved by someone, by many people. We want you here. Do not choose a permanent solution to a temporary problem. We're going to get through this. It's only money. And as my preacher, Millard Mitchell, used to say over and over again, you can't take it with you. All right? I'm with you. I've lost a large chunk of my income, but I'm going to figure out a way to get it back. And you will too. I love you. Let's hang in there.